Do you have a line of credit or a credit card in a foreign currency? Well, then you should learn how to record transactions in foreign credit card accounts. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Just like home currency credit card accounts, foreign credit card accounts are exactly the same when you record transactions in QuickBooks, except you will have a realized gain or loss for the difference in currency value between the date of the charges and the date of the payments. You therefore must make a home currency adjustment right before each credit card payment or credit card credit. For example, let's imagine on February 20, we opened a credit account with Bank of Guyana with a credit limit of 150,000 Guyanese dollars. Well, then we would have to add that account to our chart of accounts. Click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and then you would click New. Now, the type of account is credit card, and there is only one detail type, and the name of it will be Credit Card, Bank of Guyana. And as soon as you save it, you must remember to make the currency of that credit card the Guyana dollar. Notice the active currencies are up top here and easy to find. Click Guyana dollar and then click Save and Close. Exchange rate is not necessary. You're only creating the account. Now, let's imagine on February 21, we charge Gina Cassina for delivery 9,800 Guyana dollars. Well, at the moment you charge, the Guyana dollar was worth only 0.008 of the dollar back on February 21 of 2021. So what will be the result? Well, the delivery expense, Guyana credit card. Now the interesting stuff happens when we actually go to pay the balance of the credit card. On February 22nd, we pay all of the 9,800 Guyana dollars to remove the balance of what was owed to the Bank of Guyana credit card. On February 22nd, the Guyana dollar was 0.007 of the U.S. dollar. You must make a home currency adjustment or revalue the currency from the currency list, as it were, before you pay your account balances, or the balances will be out of sync in the way that we described in the prior videos. So you must adjust two accounts. And you may well ask, why do we have to adjust two accounts? Well, that's because our Guyana bank account is holding $9,800 in Guyana dollars that were previously worth 0.009 at the moment that we either adjusted or had our last transaction. And that's why the U.S. dollar balance shows $88.20. But you see, on the day that we're paying the credit card, those same 9,800 Guyana dollars are only worth 0.007. So our bank account is only worth $68.60. What that means is we actually lost $19.60 from our bank account of Guyana at the moment we pay, because the exchange rate was lower from the day that we actually adjusted or acquired the Guyana dollars. But you see, we also have Guyana dollars in the credit card balance listed in our QuickBooks records. And on the day we charged those Guyana dollars, the dollar was worth 0.008. And that means those very same $9,800 that are in the credit card records were only recorded at 0.008, and the Guyana dollars in the credit card were valued at $78.40 when we charged. Now, on the day that we pay, they're only worth 0.007. So that means that same $9,800 that we owe in Guyana dollars is now only worth $68.60. And guess what? You actually gained $9.80 between the date that you charged and the date that you're going to pay. Now, you may well ask, why is this a gain if the amount decreased? Well, it's very simple. You originally owed $78.40 in U.S. dollars on the day that you charged. But on the day that you pay, you don't owe 78 U.S. dollars. On the date that you pay, you only owe 68 U.S. dollars because of the decrease in the exchange rate. So that's why, in the case of the credit card, you gained $9.80, even though your bank account lost $19.60. So what was the net loss? Well, if you lost $19.60 on one account, but you gained $9.80 in the other account, then the net loss, which will be the net adjustment, home currency adjustment, on March 31st, before we record paying, will be $9.80. And after we pay, both accounts should be equal because they will have the same number of units, and each of those units will be valued in the same amount. To revalue the currency, we click the cog wheel and we click currency. We go to the row of Guyana dollar and we click revalue currency. Now the date is very important. It must be the date that you're revaluing, and you're going to put in the custom rate because this is only for illustration purposes. Push tab. Now you notice both of the gains and losses are listed here. For the credit card, to revalue everything to 0.007 would mean a $9.80 gain because we owe $9.80 less because the value of the Guyana dollar decreased after the charge. But on the other hand, the value of the dollars in our Guyana bank account that we are holding has decreased by $19.60. So the net gain or loss is exactly what we mentioned a moment ago. We click revalue and save, and you can see from your trial balance that the exchange gain or loss has been updated before the payment, and the balance of the Guyana bank account is now equal to the balance of the Guyana credit card. So what does that mean? It means we owe 9,800 Guyana dollars and we pay 9,800 Guyana dollars. And the balance of both Guyanese dollar accounts, bank and credit card alike, should be zero. So we click new. Now to pay the credit card, you can click expense, check, or credit card credit. I'll just click expense. And if you click expense, the way to do it here is the money is coming from the Bank of Guyana bank account, and it's going to the Bank of Guyana credit card account, which is down here. Boom. Money is coming from the Guyana bank account to the Guyana credit card account. You must be careful to put the exchange rate that you had adjusted it to, and make sure you put the correct payment date and the amount of Guyana dollars. Wipes out both balances, save and close, and the balance of the Guyana dollar bank account and Guyana dollar credit card account both finish with zero.